Pledge, please.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Remind you to please silence your electronic devices. That would be appreciated. Good evening, everyone. I call the Village of Messina Board of Trustees meeting for August 15, 2017 to order. Roll call, Mr. Offel.
Here.
Mr. Carmel.
Here.
Mr. Shea.
Here.
Mr. LeBeer.
Here.
I'm here. Reports of officers and committees, treasurer's report, Ms. Charlotte.
An updated May summary of the revenue and expense to budget is shown in your report for the five major funds. I will provide you with the final revenue and expense reports and balance sheets for those funds once the fiscal year is closed out. The annual state report for the Joint Recreation Commission for fiscal year ending 5/31/17 was electronically filed with the state comptroller on July 24. The annual report for the village is due to be filed by August 31st. I'm currently working on the report and hope to have it completed and submitted by that time. Both reports will be available in my office for your review. Through close of business Friday, we had collected $5,444,018.87, which is approximately 88.3% of the total adjusted tax mora of $6,165,315. Sales tax received from St. Lawrence County for the fourth quarter of our fiscal year was in the amount of $447,125.42. This was $11,204.40, a 2.6% increase over the same period the prior year. This brought our total tax revenue for 16-17 fiscal year to $1,750,052.86. This is an overall increase of $31,664.57, a 1.84% increase from the amount received last year. We came in $105,602.86 over our budgeted amount of $1,644,450. We have decreased our budget amount the last 2 years. So even though we came in over, we're still kind of low. This past Friday, we made a payment on the Route 37B water sewer line replacement bond. The payment consisted of $118,000 in principal and $12,431.29 in interest. The balance remaining on this bond is $248,000 and it matures in August of 2019. Craig Anderson of Tyler Technologies will be here the week of September 5th. We will be processing payroll in both our current software, Fundware, and the new software, Encode 10, to see if any issues arise that need to be worked out prior to going live the week of October 2nd. All of that.
Questions for Ms. Charlotte? Thank you. Committee reports, code enforcement, Mr. Carville, Mr. LeBeer. Economic Development Committee, Mr. Offel, Mr. LeBeer. Fire Committee, Mr. Carville, Mr. LeBeer.
We'll be meeting hopefully the last Wednesday of the month.
Personnel Committee, Mr. Carville, Mr. Shea.
We'll meet shortly for some interviews.
Police Committee, Mr. Carville, Mr. Shea.
Met with the chief, unless he has something that's been going on as usual.
Recreation Commission, Mr. Deschutes.
They had the frog jumping contest, 800 frog jumping contest, 45 kids. Competition was tough, well attended. Everybody cheered and yelled and screaming. Everybody had a good time. Trying to get a trip to go to Calvinso Park over up in Ottawa. I couldn't get enough kids to sign up for it, so I had to cancel the trip. So Mark's going to try something else next year. He's going to check with Augsburg and Potsdam and see where they go. He says it's really worth it. It's a good day for it. So it's $40 a head, so it's probably a little bit too much to get a bus full. Our grant was submitted for the roof of the arena. Something's got to be done. That's leaking like a sieve. You put a grant in and you've got to replace some doors, you want to replace the doors too. Supposed to hear from that maybe sometime this fall, maybe. Recreation program has ended, there's about 100 to 120 kids that participated in it. It's very good, keep busy during the holiday. And thing ahead, we had this annual meeting was held on August 9th, Wednesday, at the Tel Beach, our annual meeting at Tel Beach. And I was reminded to make note that the coffee that was donated by Tim Martin was very, very good. And donuts are donated by Dunkin' Donuts, naturally very good, so I just passed that comment for what it's worth. And that's the end of my report.
Thank you. Street Committee, Mr. Offeld, Mr. LeBeer.
Matt and I took a look at some issues that had come to the mayor's office as far as parking signs, no parking signs and things of that nature, but nothing to report. We signed no need for any action from the board.
I'll reach out to him tomorrow and share that and see if we can help him with that. Water and Sewer Committee, Mr. Offeld, Mr. LeBeer.
Austin's got a couple of things he's going to be talking about as the meeting progresses. One thing, I don't know if Herb can answer it or if you can answer it. What's the status of the playground, the old playground that was demolished? Are there plans to put a new one up? Where do we stand on that?
I haven't heard back from the Recreation Commission if they have any specific plans with that. I mean, we've talked and met about that entire area down there, including Collin Field, which is currently owned by the Secular Church. I've done a comprehensive plan there, but I haven't heard back from the Recreation Commission.
I just hate to see that fall off the edge.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
We'll ask. Initial public comment period. As always, we ask you to please stand, state your name for the record. Initial public comment. Sir?
My name is Tyler Chase, and I live at 18 Mulvey Avenue in the village, and I've resided there for the last 30 years. I have a couple of issues pertaining to the DPW that I'd like to bring before the board tonight. In those 40 years, I have never, ever, not once, had an issue with the services that were provided to me by the village of D.C. until recently. Approximately within the last 4 to 6 months, there's a new crew on my garbage truck. The guy that is on the recyclable truck can't do enough for you. Any problems, any questions, let me know. Thank you very much. The guy on the garbage truck, it's just the opposite. He's sarcastic, he's rude. Anything you say to him, he has a comeback. All started, I have two small dogs that are paper trained, so I have a lot of dirty newspapers in my garbage every day. I put them out in a clear bag, and with nothing else, just the newspapers, all crumbled up. The new guy says, comes along one day, and I was standing on my porch, and I saw him with something in his hand, and he was writing, and he went over to my garbage, and he put a tag on it. I opened the door, and I said, is there something wrong with my garbage? And he said, yes. He said, you've got recyclables in the garbage. And I said, no, sir, I don't. And I said, let me explain to you what the situation is. And I explained to him about my dogs. Well, he said to me, how am I supposed to know that? And I said, well, for one thing, I said, they are in a clear bag. They are all crumpled up. They are all by themselves, and they're not in with my recyclables. Well, he didn't know about that. He wasn't going to take them. And I said, well, I said, if you can't figure it out for yourself, you don't want to take my word for it, and I'll be very honest with you, I said to him, open up the bag and put it to the sniff test. Of course, he didn't like that. I know it was sarcastic, but at that point, I was a bit frustrated. He drove away. I called down to the DPW, and I forget who was in charge that day. It was some man, was several months ago, and I can't even remember his name. He thought it was a big joke. But I let him know I didn't think it was a joke. I was paying for garbage pickup, and I wanted my garbage pickup. Well, they came back and picked it up, and he said, I'll speak. Well, obviously he did, because the next week he picked up my garbage, and I didn't have any issues. Well, then they started switching up the route every week. For years, and I mean for 40 years, and all the time that I resided on Mulvey Avenue, they go up one side of Mulvey Avenue, pick up the garbage, and come down the other. never had a problem, always within the same time every week, within an hour or so, no problem. Is there variables to that? Absolutely. If there's a holiday and they got a piggyback, or there's something going on, or they're doubling up and puts the root off a little bit, I totally understand that. Not every single week. So I called down to the DPW again. I went down to the office and said, would you like to speak to the superintendent? And I said, yes, I would. And she said, well, he's in a meeting right now, but I'll have him call you back. Well, I waited almost 3 hours and I didn't hear from him. And I thought, well, maybe I should call the mayor and ask the mayor. So I called the mayor. And the mayor said, well, I'll get a hold of him and I'll have him call you back. Well, he called me back in a little over an hour from then. And the conversation started off fine and well. And I told him, I said, I don't understand. I said, for 40 years, the road has always been the same, up and down. I said, 1 week they go up Malby, the traditional way, and go down the other side. The next week they might go up South Street, be gone to one side of Malby, go up South Street, and then come back an hour later to the other side of Malby. They might start at 9 o'clock in the morning, they might start at 12 noon, they might start at 2 o'clock. And as far as that goes, I don't care. Just pick a time that you want to do it and how you want to do it and have a little bit of consistency to it. I don't like putting my garbage out and having it on the street for hours and all the animals get in. I like to know within a couple of hours when the truck is coming. When it comes, I don't care. So I told that to the superintendent. He told me that his men, it's their prerogative to switch the road up any way that they like, all for efficiency. And I said, I'm all for efficiency, but what I don't understand is, switch up the rail, try it a few different ways, decide which way is more efficient, and stick to it. But don't keep switching it up every week. I don't understand that. He got very belligerent with me, started screaming at me on the telephone because I was questioning him. I told him, I said, you need to lower your voice. When I said that to him, he screamed even louder. I told him, I didn't want to just be rude and hang the phone right up on him. I said, I'm going to hang up now, but when I hang up, I'm going to call the mayor and I'm going to let the mayor know what transpired in this phone call. I hung up the phone, I called the mayor back. I told the mayor a couple things I had heard about the superintendent. One he said was not true, the other he didn't, and I said, well, I can confirm the second one. Because, I said, I just experienced it.
I'm ready to take this to an executive session. Sure. I don't think we need to...
Right.
I don't have a problem with what you're saying. I just don't think this is the right forum for this conversation.
You just asked...
I'm ready to go to an executive session for discussing personnel.
We may be discussing personnel, but you're discussing not... this is the
hearsay of personnel.
No, it's not hearsay.
Who confirmed
I say let the gentleman finish.
Who confirmed it?
Let the gentleman finish.
I'm not in favor of it, and I'm not gonna tolerate it.
It's executive session.
Yeah, it's regarding the performance of a particular employee.
I second.
So motion and a second to enter an executive session. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
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 Aye. Opposed?
Opposed.
Executive session. Go down the hall.
Sure. Probably across.
Yeah, that'd be fine. Yeah. Across. Entertain a motion to enter back into public session.
So
Mr. Nagura, second by Mr. Offo. Discussion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Continuing public comment. Mr. Gregg.
Yes, number L on the agenda, is there a salary been set for that position?
Yep.
Can you tell us what that is?
As soon as when we make the appointment, we will tell you.
Okay, very good.
Further public comment? Seeing no more, there is no old business. This is the same amount as last year, $15,070.
So.
Mr. Offeld, second by Mr. LeBeer. Discussion? Resolution, poll individually. Mr. Offa?
Aye.
Mr. Carvel?
Aye.
Mr. Deshaies?
Aye.
Mr. LeBeer?
Aye.
Resolution carries. Proposed resolution, renew liability insurance and risk management services through Arthur Gruje Gallagher Company. first and foremost, thank the clerk and department heads and everyone that played a role in this. This is a daunting task, going through inventory and all of our risk and whatnot, so. This is a $5,066 increase over last year, just under 4% for $132,885. Their explanation to us when we sat down with them and went through it was just a little bit higher value in some of the vehicles and stuff that we purchased. So the value that they're insuring is raised, so that's reflected in the premium. So, Mr. LeBeer.
Okay.
Second by Mr. DeShays. Discussion? Resolution poll individually, Mr. Offeld.
Aye.
Mr. Carvel.
Aye.
Mr. DeShays.
Aye.
Mr. LeBeer.
Aye.
Resolution carries. Resignation. Reverend George Middleton, Community Development Board, effective July 31st, 2017. He is relocating.
So moved.
Second. Mr. Offeld, second by Mr. DeShays. Discussion? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. We have a resignation. Josie Hardy, Department of Public Works Administrative Assistant. Projected to be on September 12th.
So moved.
Mr. Offeld.
Second.
Mr. LeBeer. Discussion? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Authorization to canvass for the Department of Public Works clerical position.
So moved.
Mr. LeBeer.
Second.
Second, Mr. Offeld. Discussion?
Do you need a clerk during the
All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. F, proposed resolution, accept and authorize execution of right-of-way and easement L Avenue properties.
So moved.
Mr. Offeld.
Second.
Second by Mr. Carvel. Discussion? Resolution poll individually. Mr. Offeld.
Aye.
Mr. Carvel. Mr. DeShays.
Aye.
Mr. LeBeer.
Aye.
Resolution carries. Discussion, Aluminum Trail Project. Mr. Fayad.
Yes, this obviously is one of the people to discuss this project. We've been at it for almost 9 years now in regards to the Aluminum Trail, which is the Footbridge area. We have been having discussions with Department of Transportation because of the funding source, that being the TEP, which is the Transportation Enhancement Program. Because no action has been taken on this project thus far, they're requiring us to do an asbestos screening on the project itself. They're also requesting that we re-inspect the bridge and do an additional deck design per DOT. So in order for us to do that, there's gonna be an additional engineering cost of $50,000. So prior to this, the village's share, prior to our discussions with DOT, was almost $440,000 that we would have to commit to make this project occur. Now since we have these new costs, with all the inspection costs, you got to be NICE certified, and that's another gamut that we got to deal with. They don't just let any type of inspector inspect that project. It's got to be a NICE certified inspector. And so, although I have my professional engineer's license, I still don't qualify because I don't have that certification from the state DOT. So what they're requiring is that individual being NICE certified, if they being DOT was the ones to do the inspection of that bridge, and if they see a deficiency in that bridge in any way possible, then they're going to say, well, it's up to them to replace that, but the village is going to absorb the cost of that. So it's really something to think about. It's almost like opening up our purse strings and allowing them to tap our funds, which I'm not so comfortable with. The other component is we can hire a NICE certified inspector that does not work for the state. That's another component that we could look at, the option. But nonetheless, the individual's got to be NICE certified. So today what we're looking at, the village's share with the additional cost, the engineering cost that we got to do, we're looking at a village's share of $546,000. And again, should the village not elect not to proceed with the project, we're told that we have to pay back the TEP portion, the reimbursed amount to date, which is currently about $252,000. And we get nothing for it other than a set of plans that look good.
How many years has this been?
I think since 2008. I believe the drop dead date for this project is 2019.
Again, so you're looking at, we've spent $252,000. Our share is $516,200. So another $264,000.
The current engineering cost that we spent to date is $315,000.
I'm sorry, I thought you said, where'd you get the 252?
252, 80% of that was reimbursed by TEP, so the other, that was $252,000, so the balance was paid for by the village. That's currently. Now, if we have to spend another $50,000, that is also going to be subject to that program.
What are they going to do? They think the asbestos grew out there or what? Usually when they do the initial inspection is when you find that asbestos doesn't grow.
It's a very frustrating process.
Right.
And they think they need to do another lead abatement on the lead study on the bridge itself, and they need to do the asbestos screening. That's what they request or require.
What was the certification that they wanted?
NICET certified.
NICET?
NICET, NICET certified.
Okay, so New York State Professional Engineers are getting that?
No, I guess not.
I'll just check. Money grab.
It's frustrating.
Day one was a money grab.
Gordon, the report we got here says, not included in the supplementary agreement, everything down through. How can you figure it out? I mean, there on the second sheet, there's section 3, preliminary design, not included. How can you create a new business or something like that? That's ridiculous.
Well, this thing was, right from the start, was a nightmare. The way you even went about finding a contractor is, you didn't ask the contractor what the price was. You decided, well, we like, out of A, B, and C, we like C. So we're going to get, now that we've picked a contractor, now we'll find out what he charges. And then we'll go along that route. And he can just charge us what he wants through the rest of the contract. That's how crazy some of these grants are. And it's maybe a good learning experience a lot of times now is if you're going to get a grant, get it for something you need or going to do anyways. If it's just for a project, a fantasy or whatever, don't get involved with them because they're crazy. They don't make any common sense how they go about right from the start. It's just there's no common sense when you get into the federal government.
The 546, the new village share, that includes money already spent.
Yes.
So additional expenditures going forward is to something as well then?
No, I'm sorry. So the total project cost right now is, if we decide to go forward and we have to spend the additional $50,000, the total project cost would be $1,885,000. So the difference between the expense and the funding is $731,000. So that leaves the balance, the village's share would be the $546,200. Let me see if I explained that right.
So $546,000 to go forward?
Yes.
To?
That's what our outlay is going to be, $546,000, additional outlay.
And if we do nothing, we're on the hook for how much, $252,000?
Yes.
What a mess.
See, I thought we covered this with them many moons ago, so we were going for it. I mean, it's positive, though, because we even talked about...
We were ready to proceed, we met with them, and we were throwing some chains, some curveballs.
That's correct.
Yeah, we were talking about putting the, they wanted light, maybe a certain type of light, maybe they wanted the stripes on the parking lot, angle a certain light. The little parking lot down that, wouldn't that be the north end of the footbridge?
That, we've since removed that component out of the project. This project was scaled to go from East Orvis Street all the way to the intake initially. But now it's just scaled to the bridge itself.
Who owns the drawings if we walk away?
We own the ones, yeah, we paid for them.
So you've got $252,000 worth of drawing?
They better look good.
What's the goal here, Karen?
What do we have to tell them?
Again, the drop dead date for the project is 2019. So we need to know, if we're going to move forward with this, we need to have a construction season of 2018, next year. Again, everything's got to be put together, the inspection's got to be performed between now and probably the end of this year. But then we go out and bid in the winter, construct next year.
So if we table this for the next meeting, which is in 2 weeks.
Okay.
Good. I'm going to think about it, we'll put some funding options in.
The other thing that the mayor and I found out was in inquiring about the TEP funding. DOT has never been put in a position where they've had to ask for the money back. So we might be breaking new ground there doing something. I don't know if they'll ever come after, but we'll put that out there.
Okay, relax, mate.
Yeah.
All right, sir, over that. Thank you, Mr. Fayette. H, authorize CWSRF capital project change order number 1-3, the sanitary sewer system improvements contract for North Country Contractors. Mr. Fayette.
This is in regards to our wastewater treatment plant, our wastewater trunk main project off of Bailey Road in between Bailey and East Orvis Street on the west side of 37. There's two components to this change order, one being survey alignment in front of Jehovah's Witnesses. The initial study put out by C2AE, actually Berg and Miniac back then, in their software package, they ran the hydraulic study of that pipe, of the new pipe being put in. How it was shown was it goes to, the pipe flow goes to the manhole in the middle of Bailey Road, takes a 90-degree turn, goes down to the next manhole on Bailey Road, and then takes another 90-degree turn to run down across the highway. So I didn't like, although it worked at that point, it worked. The hydraulic study worked. I felt it was necessary. If we're going to do it, let's do it right. So instead of having the two 90-degree turns, I elected to have a more linear approach going from the top manhole strictly straight down so that we don't have a retardation of flow, basically back and flow up. So this is going to minimize it even that much more. So I requested an alignment. So $1,400 of that change order was towards the alignment, survey alignment. The other was when the project was designed and bid. It was designed and bid showing grass in the Blevins, behind the Blevins property. So the sewer main goes behind Blevins. It was all grass and grade. So when they came here to do the work, to do the job, Blevins apparently put a parking lot in the back there consisting of crushed stone. So that's the other component to this thing. So that's the two components of that one change order.
So moved.
Mr. Alfo.
Second.
Second by Mr. Lebeer. Discussion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.
Along those lines, if I may, Tim, what's the status of that? Where?
On that project?
Yeah.
They are complete with the installation of the new sewer line. They put the new benches in on the bottom of the sewer manholes. Tomorrow, we're going to camera the sewer line itself to make sure there's no obstructions, no gravel, no deflection, major deflection. In fact, they checked it for air testing and they checked the deflection. So we're moving forward to that end. Once we get a clearance from the video that pipe is in adequate shape, then what we're going to do is turn the flow into the new pipeline. And what they got to do then is abandon the old pipeline. And how we're going to do that, how the state wants us to do that, is put what they call flowable fill in the existing line, so if it does collapse, it's not going to go far.
Right. Through the whole thing, or just through the ends?
No, just the state right away.
Oh.
Not the whole thing.
Okay, that'd be a lot.
Yeah.
So across the highway?
Across the highway. There's several manholes in the lane, the northbound lane of that highway.
Yeah.
They're going to be abandoned. They're going to be brought down 3 foot below grade, then rebuilt back up with.
What about the connection at the other?
They're connected.
The Bailey Road end is connected.
The other end is.
What about that behind Blevins? Isn't that where you're picking it up?
Yeah. So they did the directional drill, the bore right underneath the connector street. Orbis, no, going from.
Oh, you're on Orbis. Okay.
So then they're going. They made the connection.
Okay.
To that East Orbis Street manhole.
There's well, they a, did.
They have done that already. Yeah.
Okay. So you only have one dirty connection to make, I guess, is for lack of a better term.
Yeah, they have what they call bypass pumping.
Okay.
They have a big old 8-inch pump that takes it from one manhole and puts it in the stuff. I know.
Yeah.
But anyway, yeah.
Yep. Good.
Pretty involved, yeah.
Good.
Dark.
Thank
you. Yes. I propose resolution, approved professional service agreement with Capital Consultant Architecture and Engineering, C2AE, for engineering services related to the Cook Street Water Main Replacement Project. Mr. Fayad.
This project is going to commence on Monday, this coming week, and the engineer who's going to provide the inspection services, but they've also they're going to do the work on the submittal and shop drawings. They didn't put enough money in our project, but they put most of the money in the Norport portion of the project. So although the net difference is not going to be change for the entire project, our two phases, they're going to take that allocation and put it into the village's portion. But even with that, the village, for the tap-on fee,
J, proposed resolution to authorize and support local government citizens reorganization empowerment grant program application. As you know, we have representatives from the Department of State earlier this year. This is the local government efficiency program that's administered by the Department of State, which provides financial and technical assistance to local governments for planning and implementation of activities necessary for the reorganization of municipal governments and government functions in order to provide an opportunity for local government officials to examine and implement new initiatives that can help reduce the growth in municipal expenses and introduce new efficiency in the delivery of services. We have been in discussions with the town. They will consider this tomorrow night at their board meeting. The way the process would work, if you authorize this, we will complete the application and send it in. Once we get approval, then we would proceed to issue RFPs. If the town agrees to join us, that would be a joint RFP. If other neighboring municipalities that are in discussions with decide, that could be a joint with them also. So that would drive our costs down even more than more people that would be involved in it. So moved. Mr. Luger.
Second.
Second by Mr. Deshaies. Discussion?
What if the town does not opt to join us? What I've been reading, it sounds like they're interested in taking this up. I mean, we can come back and address this resolution.
Correct. Okay. Because we can always choose not to go for the RFPs, right?
That's correct. Correct. And even if the RFPs come in, you can still say no before you accept them. So you've got at least two opportunities. Any questions? Resolution, poll individually. Mr. Otto?
Aye.
Mr. Carvin?
Aye.
Mr. Deshaies?
Aye.
Mr. Luger?
Aye.
Motion carries. Proposed resolution to waive residency requirement for certain appointed public officers. As you know, we are looking for a new treasurer to replace Ms. Charlotte when she leaves. We accepted application, or we accepted resumes back in May. We did not get anyone that we were interested in at that time. We proceeded to hire some staffing to canvas for us and to find candidates. One of the recommendations they made to us was to consider the residency issue, that should we decide to waive that, we would get an influx of applications probably and highly qualified ones. I think that recommendation has proved true given the quality of the resumes that we received. So in our discussions, we were looking at waiving the residency requirement. You'll recall back in 2011, this board, which a few of you were here for, voted to remove the residency requirement for employees. At that time, roughly about half of our employees were exempted from it, fire and police, and the other half of our employees were required to live within the village or town. So at that time, this board voted to waive that. It shows that at that time, either as an oversight or intentional, did not include the public officers, which would include the clerk and the treasurer. So there's a couple of ways we can do this. What the New York Conference of Mayors recommends is that ultimately we pass a local law if we're going to do anything, so that it's easier 10 or 20 years or 5 years from now to look at the local law and say this is what it says, or it's a resolution. So you have to go back and find those and see what was said. So that's where we are on this, what this resolution does. This resolution deals with the specific position that we're appointing tonight. In my view, it gives us an opportunity over the next few weeks to talk more about this, and then should we decide we like this or we want to do something different, we can pass that in the form of a local law.
So moved. It's rendered.
Mr. Levere, second by Mr. Carvel. Discussion. Resolution, poll individually. Mr. Otto?
Nay.
That's a no. Mr. Carvel?
Yes.
Mr. Deshaies?
Aye.
Mr. Levere?
Aye.
Resolution carries. Appointment of Kevin Felt, temporary deputy treasurer, effective September 11, 2017. It's being identified as deputy treasurer because New York State law prohibits us from having two treasurers at the same time. So until Ms. Sherlow actually retires, this title would be deputy treasurer. It would be at a $37.84 per hour rate.
So moved.
Mr. Levere.
Second.
Second by Mr. Carvel. Discussion? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Voucher warrants.
I move that the voucher signed by trustee Carvel and myself be approved.
Second by Mr. Carvel. Discussion. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Monthly reports, we have the volunteer fire department. Communication correspondence, I have none. Trustees? Closing public comment period, questions, please. Questions from the media?
I've got one in closing comment period.
Sure.
I'm just wondering what's going on the village lot on the South Racket Road. This summer, payloaders have been in there with a backup alarm beeping sometimes before 7 o'clock in the morning, many days before 8. And it appears now that they are encroaching on the Summers property next door where they're dumping materials over there. I would suggest that before they go any further, they get a line cut of the survey to find out to make sure they're staying on their own property. It appears now that they are off the property and continuing heading west. And, I mean, if you look at what happened down behind the old DPW, they went acres behind, off their property down there. Don't want the same thing to happen here and have to move the dirt again to get it out of there. I don't know what the reasoning is, why they're taking all those chips and bucketing them, dumping them off to the side of the bank there onto the, like I say, some of it's onto, I believe, onto the neighbor's property. Something should be addressed soon, and like I say, cut the property, get it surveyed, cut the property line, know exactly where you are.
I did talk to the superintendent today. The product you're talking about is going to be removed. Someone else is going to be taking that. But we're going to look at that and make sure we're not encroaching on somebody. Anything else from the trustees? I do need an executive session regarding collective bargaining pursuant to the Taylor Law regarding an employee contract. Mr. LeBeer.
Second
by Mr. Deshaies. Discussion. All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Thank you, everyone.
Expect any action, Tim?
What's that?
Expect any action.
I'm not sure.
Okay.
Can't say no for sure.
I'll shoot you an email.
Okay, thanks, fine.